Hi, welcome to Barney Tech channel. Here we are going to see a directional earthfault production with voltage production method. It is the diagram for voltage polarization method. On this, the CT may be a phase CT or neutral CT. For this connection, first we are going to see a open delta voltage. Normally, if all the three phase voltage are balanced, then this open delta will be zero. Now we are going to see some case studies. Case 1. Let us consider the fault on R phase. During this time, depending upon the fault current, the R phase voltage will be dropped. Now let us consider the voltage on R phase is 50 volt. Remaining all 110 volt. Now the open delta voltage we get is 20 volt and 180 degree angle. We will note down this value. Now I go for case 2. Let us consider the fault on Y phase. During this time, depend on the fault current on Y phase voltage, the voltage will be dropped on Y phase. Now let us consider the voltage on Y phase is 40 volt. Now the open delta voltage will be 23.3 volt and 60 degree angle. We will note down this value also. Now I go for case 3. Let us consider the fault on B phase. During this time, depend on the fault on B phase, the B phase voltage will get dropped. Now let us consider the voltage on B phase is 60 volt. After making this calculation, we can able to find the open delta voltage we get is 16.6 voltage and angle is 300 or minus 60 degree. We will note down this all three phase voltage with angle. Now we can go for calculating the current magnitude and angle during this fault condition. On case 1, now I am going to consider the fault on R phase. The R phase fault current let us take as 2.8 amps. Now I naught current we get is 0.6 amps with 180 degree. We will note down this value. On case 2, now I am going to consider the fault on Y phase. The Y phase fault current let us take 3 amps. Now I naught current we get is 0.66 amps with 60 degree. We will note down this value also. Now we go for finally a case 3. Now I am going to consider the fault on B phase. The B phase fault current let us take 3.1 amps. Now I naught current we get is 0.7 amps at 300 degree or minus 60 degree. We will note all these three values. Now I am going to use all the noted value of voltage and current, and I am going to plot it in power system diagram. In a power system diagram, we know that R phase start with 0, Y phase start with 240 and B phase start with 120. Over here, I am going to plot my earth fault value. In this, I am going to consider only the angle for reference. For R phase fault, I got on 180 degree, which is directly opposite to these phases. For Y phase, I found 60 degree, which is also directly opposite to its phase. Similarly, for B phase fault, I got minus 60 degree or 300 degree, which is also directly opposite to its main phasor angle. From this, we are clearly understand that the earth fault current will be opposite to this phasor current. Now we will see briefly on R phase 2 earth fault. For this, we have to take a V reference should be directly opposite to VR. Now for directional earth fault, we need four important things. First one is direction, second one is RCA angle, third one is pickup value, fourth one is trip time. Among this, very important one is pickup value. The fault current should be above the pickup value. Second, direction and operating region. The direction is forward, so V reference should be opposite to VR and RCA is 40. We have to consider the V reference as a reference point, and from here we have to make 40 degree towards clockwise direction and draw a line. This is a MTL. To get this angle, subtract 40 from 180, we get 140 degree. Over here draw a line. Now make MTL as a reference and take 90 degree towards a clockwise direction. To find this line, subtract 90 from 140. We got 50 degree. Over here draw a line. Now again make MTL as a reference and take 90 degree towards anti-clockwise direction. To find this angle, add 90 from 140. We get 230 degree. Over here draw a line. Now this two line is also known as zero torque line. This is also known as operating region, and other one is a non-operating region. If the fault current is above the pickup value and comes on this region, then the relay will give trip command. On other case, even though the fault current is above the pickup value and come to this region, then the relay will not get pickup and it will not give trip command. Now we are going to see for reverse directional earth fault operating region. For reverse direction, V reference should be opposite to the forward V reference, and here also we are considering RCA is 40. We have taken V reference as a reference, and from here we make 40 degree towards clockwise direction and draw a line, and this line is known as MTL. To get this angle, subtract 40 from 360 degree. We get 320 degree. Over here draw a line. Now make this MTL as a reference and take 90 degree towards a anti-clockwise direction. To find this angle, add 90 from 320 degree. We got 410 degree. It is above 360, so we convert to the corresponding angle and we get 50 degree. Over here draw a line. Now again make MTL as a reference and take 90 degree towards the clockwise direction. To find this angle, subtract 90 from 320. We get 230 degree. Over here again we draw the line. This two line is also known as zero torque line. This is known as operating region, and other this is a non-operating region. If the fault current is above the pickup value and come to this region, the relay will get pickup and give trip command. On other case, even though the fault current is above the pickup value and come to this region, the relay will not get pickup and it will not give any trip. Similarly, we can also able to find the operating region for Y phase to earth fault. And B phase to earth fault. By this, we came to the end of the section. I believe this section will be useful to you all. Stay safe and see you all on next video. Take care and bye from Barney Tech channel.